We're here in Monaco with Swiss racing driver Simona De Silvestro, now driving in the Australian Supercar Series. Simona, you used to be a Formula E driver yourself. When you soak in this exciting atmosphere here, would you want to get into the driver's seat and participate in the race yourself?
Yeah, I think for sure being a driver and being at the racetrack and not being able to drive this weekend, I think can be a little bit frustrating because you want to drive anything you can. But and for sure here also being in Monaco, I think it's kind of a bucket list type of racetrack which every driver would like to drive. And you know, maybe one day I get to drive again here, and we'll see.
Monaco is home to the most famous street racing course in the world, with races having taken place since 1929. What is it that makes the Monaco course so special?
Well, I think just with all the history here in Monaco, you know, I think you can count, you know, there's a few tracks, I would say, you know, the Indy 500, Monaco, and maybe Bathurst and Le Mans as well, that are kind of those type of tracks you want to race at. And I think just the history here and, you know, to be here with, I think, with Formula E is quite exciting as well, that they are able to race on the Formula One track.
You've been driving in the Australian Supercar Series since the beginning of the new season. What are the main differences between driving a Formula E car to driving a Supercar Series car?
Well, the biggest difference I would say between the Formula E car and the Supercar that I'm driving is definitely the electric power that Formula E is powered on. So it's quite different type of racing. In Formula E you have to really manage the energy, which in normal racing you really don't have. So that adds a challenge. And the supercars, you know, it's really tough out there. You know, you're really bumping and touching and things like that, which are quite eye-opening for me as well, coming from an open wheel background. But I would say both, you know, have their characteristic, and you know, it'd be cool to be able to drive in all different series. And I've been lucky enough to be able to drive in both series.
I suppose once you have your helmet and all your gear on and you're out on the track, you're just like everybody else out there. But once you're off the track, does your gender ever matter?
My gender, you know, it's always such a difficult question, because all I know in all my racing, you know, I've always been the only girl in the field, and I've never looked at it like as a handicap or anything like that. But for sure, I think as a woman, you have to prove yourself. You know, if I'm, especially now coming from Formula E, going to supercars, I had to prove myself. I had to prove that I belong. But yeah, I always said, you know, once you have the helmet on, we all look the same, and at the end of the day, it's the result that matters, and I think that's what's important in this sport, and that's why I think motorsport is also quite exciting, because it is the only sport where this makes it possible.
And what does it take to succeed in such a male-dominated sport?
I think the biggest thing, you know, I think, especially in racing, you know, it's maybe not the first sport a girl gets into, but the biggest thing is if you're passionate about it. I was passionate about racing. I loved cars and really wanted to become a race car driver. So I worked really hard and really told the people around me as well that that was my dream and that was my goal, and they were able to help me. And I think that's what's important, to not be shy about it and work hard for it.